The number one thing that's killing your brand is that you're not saying anything. You look like everyone else. You sound like everyone else. And so you're slaving away. You are working away. You think you're the greatest thing in the world. And yet no one even cares. I get it. When you are a business person, when you're an entrepreneur, it is hard to know what to say, how to say it. And so the first thing that you do is you go and see what everyone else is doing in your industry. How are they saying it? What are they saying? What does their website look like? And then you just take little bits and pieces, you cobble something together, and you say, here I am. But guess what? Now you are just one of the pack. You are one of the crowd. You are just like everyone else, which means there is no reason that anyone should pick you out. There's nothing that makes you special, and you just blend in. You know, when I was younger and I was getting out of film school, I just wanted desperately to be seen as good as everyone else. I didn't think that I was very good. I was young, I was inexperienced, and so I would just work, work, work. And so what did that get me after years of hard work? It got me to the point where now I was as good as everyone else. Great, now I'm like everyone else. And then I had to switch gears and work and work and work to get better than everyone else, to be different. And so I spent years trying to blend in, only to find myself now having to spend years to try and separate myself. And so I promised myself that the next time I took on a new venture, when I switched my brand, when I went into something new, I was not gonna waste any time or any energy trying to be perceived as competent or capable or like everyone else. I was gonna leapfrog that, and I was gonna go to the place where I could already be better than everyone else. And the only way to be seen as better is to be different. This is a subjective world we live in, but it takes courage. It takes an inner fortitude to be able to say, you know what? I am not gonna do the safe, comfortable thing, like go through all of my competitors and grab the bits and pieces and, oh, everyone in my industry looks this way. Everyone in my industry sounds this way. We all wear suits. You have to stand out. You have to be different. And that feels uncomfortable. That feels like a risk. Do you know how often I sit down with marketers where we talk about the brands we love, the campaigns we love, the brands we love, the entrepreneurs we love, and everyone points to those who stand out. Think of the Elon Musks. Think of these people. We look at them and we say, that's who I want to be like. That's how I want to run my company. And then the time comes to make the decision, to spend the money, to invest the time, to put yourself out there, to say the things that's a little bit risky. And guess what happens? People back down. They get scared. You don't want to offend people, so you say nothing. You don't want to put those dollars at risk because it's easy for the big brands to risk it, but for you, it's not. And so you don't risk anything. You don't test anything. You don't try anything. And so we look at these companies and these people who do the most amazing things, and we get inspired by them, and we start to take action. And then when it comes to us, we back down, we blend in, and it destroys us. And so you have to be willing to risk offending people. I'm sorry, you do. You want to say something bold? You want to say something different? Well, guess what? Some people are going to love it, and some people are going to hate it. You can't market and advertise to everyone. You can't build a brand that's attractive to the old and the young, to men and to women of every different background, of every socioeconomic class. You can't do that. You have to get specific. And to get specific, it means that you need to be comfortable ignoring whole groups of people. That's just the way it is. In my business, you know, we run an agency, and I love working with corporate people in big companies and small companies, from startups to entrepreneurs to salespeople to marketing people to international companies. But it's really hard to market and sell to all of those different people in all of those different industries because they just don't get it. You have to water down your message, and then no one knows who you're speaking to. So we go to market speaking to entrepreneurs in medium-sized companies. Does that mean we're missing the big guys and the small guys? Yeah. Does it mean that we're missing the people in corporate clients? Of course. Does that bother me? Yes. But to be able to build a brand that stands for something, you have to actually stand for something. What do you stand for? What makes you unique? What makes you different? What can you say that only you can say? How can you say it in a way that is 100% authentically you? If you spend all your time worrying about how you look compared to others, then you are focusing on the wrong thing. You know what your unique selling proposition is? You. Your voice, your perspective, your tone, what makes you you. Take the best elements of that, take the essence of that, and triple down on it. Make sure that in every message, in every part of your website, in all of your photography, in your branding, in your advertising, in everything you do, how you answer the phone. Take that essence of what makes you you and then just go all in on it. Stop worrying about how you compare to those in your industry. Stop being afraid of the fact that everyone wears suits and I'm not gonna wear a suit. Stop trying to blend in and start building a brand that is not only worth listening to, but the type of brand that I love to love. If you're struggling with branding, marketing, advertising, check out this video right here. I think you would learn a lot, and it would mean a lot to me if you subscribe to my channel.